Fisheries biologists with the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission use a technique known as electrofishing, or shocking, to sample fish populations in public waters of North Carolina from the mountains to the coast. To electrofish, biologists use an electrofishing boat equipped with a generator and a special control box to send electrical current into the water. This current attracts and temporarily stuns the fish so that biologists can capture them easily with nets. To operate an electrofishing boat, two people are needed. One person drives the boat while the other, the dip netter, stands on the bow of the boat with a long-handled net to pick up fish as they are drawn to the electricity. Once in the net, the fish are brought onto the boat and placed in a recovery tank where they stay for a few moments. As the fish recover, biologists take them out of the tank to weigh and measure them. Occasionally, a few scales are taken from the fish to learn more about the fish's age and growth. Sometimes reward tags are placed on the fish. The fish are then released, unharmed, back into the water. Sampling fish with an electrofishing boat is efficient, quick, and relatively safe if conducted properly by trained personnel. All Division of Inland Fisheries biologists have been thoroughly trained in electrofishing procedures and safety considerations. No one should electrofish without proper certified training. Safety measures have been built into the boat to prevent the boat's occupants from being electrocuted accidentally. First and foremost, everyone on the boat is required to wear rubber gloves and rubber boots. They also wear life jackets at all times. The driver and the dip netter have separate foot pedals. Both pedals must be pushed down at the same time to send electrical current into the water. If for some reason the dip netter on the bow of the boat loses his footing and is thrown overboard, the front pedal is released and the electrical circuit is broken before he makes contact with the water. By electrofishing, biologists can find out what's happening underwater without hurting the fish. Electrofishing is an important management tool that biologists use to determine many things about a fish community, such as the number of fish, the types of fish, the age of the fish, and whether the fish are healthy or diseased. Biologists take the information they've gathered from electrofishing to develop management plans that improve fish populations and ultimately fishing opportunities for North Carolina anglers.